Hello and welcome. My name is Andreas Geilus, and I'm the chair of the Department of Germanic Languages and Literatures. We put together a little graduation video for you, dear students, to celebrate your amazing achievement and mark this important day. To get us started on a high note, we begin with a medley of melodies that Vicky Dischler and her students in the class German in Song recorded for you.
Eins und zwei und drei und vier und fünfzig, 74, 90, 2010. Ja, wir stimmen sie alle ein. Mit dem Herz in der Hand und der Leidenschaft im Bein werden wir Weltmeister sein. Wir und fünfzig, 74, 90, 2010. Ja, wir stimmen sie alle ein. Mit dem Herz in der Hand und der Leidenschaft im Mann werden wir Weltmeister sein. Ist meine Hand ein Haus, machst du sie wieder auf, wirst du deine in meiner. Sätze nicht bedacht, durch all den Lärm, als ob sie mein Sextant und Kompass wären. Applaus, Applaus für deine Worte, mein Herz geht auf, wenn du lachst. Applaus, Applaus für deine Art, wirst du begeistern.
Herzlichen Glückwunsch! Ich mache nie etwas fertig, aber Sie haben es geschafft. Ich wünsche Ihnen viel Erfolg, viel Spaß und viel Deutsch in Ihrer Zukunft.
This is not the way we plan to celebrate your graduation. I know how much you had looked forward to this day, how disappointing it must be to not take a picture with your parents on the Diag, or go to the big house to hear Al Gore speak, or party with your friends in the days leading up to this event. You have worked hard for this moment, and it is simply unfair that you don't get to celebrate it publicly and on a grand scale. And the same goes for you, dear parents. 4 years of paying for college and then this? Believe me, we understand your disappointment. But let the circumstances not take away from the occasion we are celebrating today. This is a moment of joy and pride, especially for you, the graduating majors and minors. After arduous studying, after heavy coursework, after some worrying, and perhaps also some partying, you will graduate from the University of Michigan. This is a life-defining moment. A moment that is bound to come with a sense of tremendous relief, as well as, I hope, with a great sense of accomplishment. You have succeeded, you have overcome challenges, you have flourished. Bravo. Take a second to think back to who you were when you first walked into the halls of this university. You will find that you have grown in ways both expected and unexpected. For example, you might consider your first language classes with us and reflect on how much you have improved your skills and mastered the bewildering maze of German syntax. Remember your first visit to the Language Resource Center? Your first meeting with Cully or Mary, our amazing undergraduate advisors? Many of you went to Germany during your studies. Perhaps you attended a Goethe Institute language course, or interned at a German corporation, in healthcare, or in government agencies. Some of you participated in our study abroad programs in Tübingen or Friday. While abroad, Many of you have fallen in love with what you experienced. You have built ties with German-speaking friends. International education gives life-changing experiences that stay with you. We often think of university studies in terms of acquiring knowledge, but perhaps just as important is the opportunity to set aside or bracket what you already know in order to experience the world and yourself in new ways. That requires the courage to open up and make yourself vulnerable, a courage that you have shown when you stepped into a foreign language classroom. Think about it. When you start college, you may not yet know much about statistical computing or the ethnic makeup of the Ottoman Empire, but you already are a fully competent speaker of your native language, an English or Spanish or Chinese language adult. Stepping into German classes, let alone going to Germany, meant letting go of that adult competency. It meant exposing yourself consciously and willingly to the inability of being able to say what you want to say, and hence inviting feelings of insecurity and vulnerability that come with not being fully in control of a situation. You cannot learn a foreign language without feeling, at least from time to time, pretty stupid. Cherish that feeling of not being in control, of not knowing. It is more important than ever. One of the aspects that makes the situation we are now in so terrifying is that we know very little about the virus that caused it. We need to act, but we cannot fall back on already existing solutions. I'm afraid that this combination of global threat and uncertainty is not limited to the coronavirus. Your generation will need to find new solutions to other global problems that are already with us. Whether environmental, social, or economic, the old ways of thinking, the old solutions aren't working any longer. In fact, they have gotten us into the mess we are in. In such a situation, the ability to admit that you do not yet know how to respond to the world around you is not the worst attitude. But that is for tomorrow and the day after that. Today, we are celebrating you, the German majors and minors of the class of 2020. You have worked hard, and today you should look back proudly on your achievements. We are fortunate to have gotten to know all of you during these past 4 years, both inside the classroom and beyond. We hope that you'll stay in touch in the future. Send us postcards. Send us your younger friends and siblings. Keep us up to date on the address where we can send you our annual newsletters. We can't wait to find out where your life will take you. But for now, we bid you farewell and congratulate you.
Hallo, ich gratuliere Ihnen zum Abschluss. So sonnig wie heute soll Ihr Leben immer sein.
Congratulations. You've made fabulous achievements. All the best for your future.
Ich gratuliere! Ich wünsche euch alle viel Erfolg! Habe ich das richtig gesagt?
Ja, Bea, du hast das sehr gut gesagt. Wir gratulieren.
And congratulations to all the German minors. Taye Adolphus, Nathan Amann, Allison Bailey, Jade Beauregard, Alexandra Broussard, Jackson Bridges, Lauren Camp, Anna Chambers, Aditya Chandraskaran, Yinghui Chen, Guilherme Costa Nascimento, Noah Dobos, Peter Eklund, Anthony Edgar, Melanie Ermler, Katarina Evers, Amy Pham, Robert Fenton, Chloe Ferguson, Kyle Folo, Jack Geiger, Charles Graham, Zachary Hempel, Emily Hansen, Simon Herndel, Alexis Hoffman, Kevin Hu, Ella German, Mark Canaris, Duncan Coomer, Atharva Kumthakar, Daniel Lee, Donglin Lee, Yuhang Lee, Christine Lightfoot, Ashley Mark, Louise Marr, James Morgan, William Nederlander, Abby Nelson, Joshua Nichols, John Novak Jr., Luis Orozco, Daniela Osorio de Brito, Ronnie Frank Perez Stone, Zachary Puzar, Evan Raker, Lindsay Rasmussen, Sarah Rydell, Jennifer Schlafhauser, Brandon Schulte, Christine Schultz, Aaron Snyder, Kira Sorigan, Jaden Sowash, Samuel Teray, Nisa Thodesen Kasparian, Caroline Michelle Wee, Teresa Vale, Matthew Ward, Nina White, Anastasia Woody, Mark Ji, Jonathan Yang.
Today is the day of your graduation. And well, one thing, all of you will graduate with a virtual summa cum laude. If there's any group that can plow through this in creative ways, it is your group. There's no pandemic strong enough to silence you or dent the passion of your generation. Keep your head up and keep fighting. We all need you because you provide hope for our future. This year may not be what you envisioned, but we are eager to see what you do with it. Congratulations to the class of 2020.
These are the names of the German majors of the class of 2020. Taim Ala Al-Jarrah, Larissa Barab, Ty Buffington, Paul Chamberlain, Casey Conley, Diana Davis, Andrew Drumheller, Ian Elphinstone, Rhea Epperson, Sophia Furkey, Sam Franz, April Hadwick, Colin Im, Alexander John, Micah Johnson, Colton Cartman, Cameron Crow, Alyssa Cuntley, Emily Lehman, Hai Lin, Jennifer Long, Mark Lynch, Brandon Massey, Erica Myers, Owen Miller, Zoe Moore, Jordan Niehoff, Spencer Orlando, Mehul Pandey, Natasha Pietruszka, Caroline Randall, Brian Sahida, Hans Schuler, Monica Sloan, Alexander Spranger, Austin Stanford, Yicheng Tao, Jeremy Turvo, Nicole Tomczak, Olivia Vuitton, Courtney Weigel, Elizabeth Wood, Nicole Ju. Congratulations to all the graduating German seniors of the class of 2020.
This is Abschied von gestern, one of my favorite films by Alexander Kluge, and some of you picked through this complex film with me this semester. But today I use it not to say Abschied von gestern, but alles Gute für die Zukunft. Congratulations, class of 2020.
Congratulations to our Swedish minor grad, Kari Sieres.
Hallo alle, herzlichen Glückwunsch zum Studienabschluss und ich wünsche Ihnen viel Freude bei Ihrem neuen Abenteuer. Tschüss!
It is a tremendous feat to graduate during a pandemic. It is an even more astounding accomplishment to cap a few years at the University of Michigan with an honors thesis. I'm thrilled to present to you our three German honors graduates. Carmen Rosarida explored one of the most urgent issues engaging Germany now in her thesis titled The Many Faces of Integration, Understanding the Role of Art and Community in the Creation of Refugee Identities, advised by Johannes von Moltke. Nicole Tomczak tackled the question of recycling and related matters in, quote, More Than Garbage, a cultural and political history of waste collection in Germany, advised by Andreas Geilus. And last, Elizabeth Wood thought about the intricate challenges facing literary translators with regard to one of Germany's most important and difficult poets. Her thesis is titled Paul Celan in Translation, Exploring the Borders of Language, advised by Kristen Dickinson. The three of you, we are so very, very proud of you. Congratulations and well done.
Congratulations, class of 2020. I celebrate you all with a collage that was created by Hannah Höch 101 years ago in 1919. And it's this collage with this impossible long name that some of you have encountered in class with me. And its title is Schnitt mit dem Küchenmesser Dada durch die letzte Weimarer Bierbauch-Epoche Deutschlands. Take this collage as a Dada time capsule and let yourself be sent off with the help of this capsule. Stay strong, stay creative. And don't forget to come back and visit.
Today, we also honor and celebrate three graduate students who defended their dissertations this year. And we thank our faculty colleagues who advised them so ably and saw them through to the finish line. Our students' projects are testament to the brilliance and originality of our wonderful PhD students. And we are tremendously proud of them. They are Karl de Fong, Bergbau, Tagebau, Umbau, the post-industrial landscape aesthetics of repurposed coal mines. Andrea Rottmann, Queer Home Berlin, making queer selves in spaces in the divided city, 1945 to 1970. And Naomi Vaughan, the new Reich Chancellery and Representation, the intermedial architecture and archive of Hitler's Space of Power. Congratulations, Drs. Fong, Rottmann, and Vaughan. We salute you. We wish you nothing but the very best for your futures, as uncertain as these futures might be right now. We do know that your intelligence, your grit, and your creativity will serve you well wherever you go. Congratulations.
Ich.
Und ich.
Und ich.
Und ich.
Und ich.
Und ich.
Und ich.
Wir gratulieren zum Abschluss.
Ooh, bravo! Congratulations, class of 2020. I can't wait to see where your futures take you. Woo!
Herzlichen Glückwunsch. Tschüss und auf Wiedersehen.